Gusselby, midden in het bosrijke hart van Zweden. Een rustig dorp van zo'n 300 inwoners. Tot de vluchtelingencrisis zich ook hier laat voelen en de regering er in 2014 een asielcentrum opent.
As you see, it's deserted. No one is here anymore. But this used to be a place where we have young offenders living here in an not prisons, but in an open treatment thing. And after that, during the asylum seekers, a lot of people came to Sweden, especially in the fall of 2015. So they stayed here. In this municipality, we received like a lot of people, and we are very proud of that.
Bengt Storbakka is voorzitter van de gemeenteraad en lid van de Sociaaldemocraten. Jarenlang de grootste partij in dit dorp. Tot in 2014. De rechtspopulistische Zweden-Democraten halen er een recordscore van 37%. Een nationaal record.
Sinds het een small village is. Imagine a population of 300 spread out in this quite nice area of Sweden. Almost the same size, or even sometimes more people from another part in the world. Of course, it raises questions.
Hi. Ja, vi ringer på oss där för att de ville träffa någon.
Jaha.
De är från Belgien. De pratar engelska.
Jaha. Vad vill de då?
De vill fråga om hur det är att bo i Gusselby. De
är jättetillsammans.
Ja, du ska vara ärlig.
Can I ask, which part did you choose?
Yes.
SD. Vad heter de?
Swedish Democrats.
Ja, Swedish Democrats, yes.
And why did you vote for Sweden Democrats?
I want them to have a little to say in the government.
De Zweden-Democraten scoren met hun standpunten over migratie en veiligheid. Want steeds meer Zweden voelen zich onveilig. 1 op de 5 heeft 's avonds schrik om alleen op straat te lopen. Bij vrouwen is dat bijna 1 op de 3.
I think we have one of the lowest rates of police officer compared to inhabitants compared to the rest of Europe. I think my area actually has a lot of police officers, but some other parts of Stockholm actually send their police officers to work in my area. So I think we have to be more police officers out on the streets.
Niklas Andersen is korpschef in het noorden van Stockholm en verantwoordelijk voor het probleemgebied Rinkeby. 90% van de inwoners is hier van niet-Zweedse origine.
Rinkeby is one of the vulnerable areas here in Stockholm because of the crimes also because of people are feeling unsafe in all kind of different matters. But we are making a big change now, I think. We have big problems with drugs and of course some violence, all kinds of violence, both domestic violence and violence out on the streets. I think that's the most common.
We've been campaigning here, knocking doors here, and we can see that most people around are very concerned about the youth criminality. With this drug dealing or shooting that has been, and burning cars and so on.
De Sociaaldemocraten willen 10.000 extra agenten op straat en kiezen ook voor een strenger asiel- en migratiebeleid. Maar de partij ontkent dat dat een antwoord is op de stijgende populariteit van de rechtspopulisten.
I can absolutely see why a lot of people are concerned about the development. We need to do more to stop the segregation in the big cities like Malmö, Stockholm and Göteborg. And we must address this even more. But mostly because of that people are asking for it, not because of that a populistic and a party with racist background. I think all of the people who lives, no matter where in Sweden, are a part of this country and deserves better living standard and living condition. Even if it is everything from welfare to a right to have police around when you need them.
My general view is that the Social Democratic Party is a very pragmatic party. We used to make big solutions. So I'm proud in that sense. But I'm not proud in the way we talked about these issues, because we talked about almost foreigners as a problem. That's not a problem. The problem is how you deliver the service of the society, how you the injustice between different groups and so on. That's the real politics that matters.